This is the most common cause of fatal acute coronary syndrome. The cap that typically overlies the lipid-rich center of an atheromatous plaque is very important because it stands between the blood component with its latent coagulation factors and the thrombogenic lipid core. So it is because of the fibrous cap that the blood and lipid core does not come into contact. So obviously, when there is any derangement in the fibrin cap, the coagulation factors interact with the thrombogenic material and you get an acute coronary syndrome. So look at this plaque that is ruptured. You can see that there is a large lipid pool. You can see the thin fibrous cap that is ruptured and has produced a thrombus. And you can also see that there is no stenosis. Just before the myocardial infarction, just before the thrombus occurred, you can see that there is hardly any stenosis. And you can also see the positive outmodeling or the remodeling outwards of the vessel. And if you look at the longitudinal section, you can see that there is no stenosis and there is a large plaque burden which is actually modeled outward, remodeled outwards. This, on the other hand, is a chronic stable angina, where you can see that there is hardly any lipids, hardly any cholesterol, but there is a lot of calcium, there is a thick fibrous cap, and you can see there is stenosis which can produce angina. And you can see the cross section, the longitudinal section, showing a constrictive remodeling also.